If you're not familiar with the hype and possibilities for graphene, be sure to check out the video at the outro of this video. In this episode, we'll find out if this right here really is the fastest charging power bank in the world. And yes, it fits in my wife's jean pocket, so yup, it's portable. This power bank retails for $59.50 and can be found on Amazon. I've included the link to the most updated version of the product in the description below. In the box, you'll find a soft velour carrying case, the power bank, a USB-C cable, a 60-watt supercharger cable, and the instruction manual. The back of the box lists some specs, which we'll cover in the next 40 seconds. The capacity is 10,000 milliamp hours. This just means it can power a device drawing 100 milliamps for 100 hours. Generally, a higher milliamp hour rating will result in a larger battery capacity. The bank itself is charged via the 60-watt supercharger via a USB-C cable, and there are four output options available on this device. Two USB-A ports, a USB-C port, and yes, it does indeed have wireless charging. The 60-watt supercharger plugs into the port labeled In-Out, but there's also an input port to charge with a standard micro USB. The LCD screen is on the left, and there is an on-off button on the right. When fast charging, a green indicator light will light up on the LCD screen. Let's get into the real-world tests. This Real Graphene bank claims to have the fastest recharge speeds on the market. To be specific, the power bank itself is supposed to recharge at blazing speeds. Yes, it does charge other devices quickly as well, but you do need special cables to maximize the speeds. More on that later. I ran the graphene power bank to zero and then recharged using the supplied 60-watt supercharger plugged directly into a regular wall outlet. It took only 50 minutes and 15 seconds to go from 0 to 100%. For a 10,000 milliamp hour battery, that's really impressive. For context, I ran the same test with a comparable 10,000 milliamp anchor power bank, one of the most popular on Amazon, also linked below. It took 7 hours, 58 minutes, and 39 seconds to charge from 0 to 100%. 7 hours to recharge the exact same capacity as the Real Graphene power bank. This right here is what I like to call a game changer, and this aspect alone makes this a great purchase for my use cases. To make sure that this device does actually serve its purpose of charging other devices, here are the other tests we ran. The next test was charging my iPhone 11 Pro Max from a 10% state of charge to 80%. As with most lithium-ion batteries, it's best to avoid 0 and 100% states of charge if you're concerned with the longevity of the battery. I used the exact same charging cable, a 3-foot cable from Anker. Once again, I ran the exact same test with the Anker power bank. Keep in mind, this test is not using any special quick charging cable, as the only cable included with the Real Graphene product is a USB-C that of course does not charge Apple products. Thus, these tests do indeed handicap the Real Graphene test results, but I wanted to show you what performance you can expect with only what's included with this purchase. And for the results, the Anker power bank took 1 hour and 10 minutes, whereas the Real Graphene power bank took 2 hours and 28 minutes using the same cable. Charging my iPhone from 10 to 80% resulted in the Real Graphene power bank going from a 100% state of charge down to 60% capacity on the LCD readout. It also resulted in the Anker power bank going from 4 LEDs lit up down to 3, indicating a remaining charge between 50 and 75%, right on par with the Real Graphene. The next test was the wireless charging. I can't wirelessly charge my iPhone as I have a pop socket on the back. So yes, feel free to roast me for this in the comments if you'd like. Because of this, I use my wife's iPhone 11 Pro. We set her phone on the graphene power bank at 9% state of charge, and it took 1 hour and 50 seconds to charge to 81%. And if you're wondering, yes, it does still charge with a case on your phone. This took the power bank from 60% capacity down to 22%. The last test we performed was charging two cell phones simultaneously. We let the phones charge for 20 minutes to simulate a potential real-world scenario. My iPhone went from 14% to 37% state of charge in that 20 minutes via the USB 2 port using a shorter cable. My wife's iPhone went from 44% to 57% state of charge via the wireless charging option. In this 20 minutes charging two devices, the power bank went from 100% capacity down to 75%. So yes, you can charge two and actually up to four devices simultaneously with this product. Perhaps more importantly, I was able to charge my iPhone from 10% back up to 80% roughly 2.5 times before the Real Graphene power bank would run out of juice. This product weighs 290 grams or 0.6 pounds, but it feels very sturdy and solid. It does fit in my wife's jeans comfortably, but because the charge ports are on the side and you'll be putting this in your pocket vertically, you need to be careful so as to not damage the cables. The power bank itself is beautiful to look at, but because of its glossy finish on the top and bottom, it will absolutely show fingerprints. The on-off button has a solid tactile feel and sound, and I know the tests we ran were not exhaustive, but my aim was to give you a general understanding of what you can expect if you purchase this Real Graphene power bank. As you can see, this product is excellent when it comes to how fast the power bank recharges, and it's acceptable in terms of the speed at which it charges other devices with standard cables. Bear in mind, if using a quick charging cable, the output charging time should drop significantly. And if you use a cable shorter than 3 feet, the charging speeds will increase greatly, as you could see with my iPhone gaining 23% battery life in just 20 minutes using a shorter cable. Once again, links to the products mentioned in this episode are linked below. If you like tech or Tesla, please consider subscribing and hitting the bell so you don't miss future episodes. Thank you to all of our Patreon supporters. We appreciate your help as every bit brings us closer to being able to produce content full time. I'll see you guys in the next episode.